here and sold there. That was a sign on Peddly Polly's cart as she pulled up on Main Street. Peddler Polly looked around and smiled.
I'm sure glad to be back in Tail Town. Imagine a town where everyone tells stories.
Peddler Polly parked at Town Square. Over on Town Hall, she saw a notice. Story swap today. Bring a story, if you still know one.
If you still know one?
Hello, Peddler Polly.
Came a sad little girl's voice.
Well, it's my old friend Penny. Do you have a good story for me? I'd gladly trade for something from my cart.
Penny sobbed and sniffled.
I don't have any stories at all. Hardly anyone in Tell Town does. We're all losing our stories.
Losing your stories? Whatever do you mean?
We start to tell a story and then it's gone. We can't remember it anymore. Come to Story Swap this afternoon and see.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls.
Another cart had parked on the square. Its sign said, Dr. Sebastian Spellbinder, Entertainment Paraphernalia. In the cart stood a man with a top hat, top coat, and a goatee, surrounded by piles of wooden boxes. A crowd was gathering before him.
You've heard of a storyteller, and you've heard of a storybook. Well, I'm here to show you something finer still. The brand new painted Spellbinder story box.
Oh, Peddler Polly, he's selling stories.
Dr. Spellbinder held up one of the wooden boxes, showing a pane of glass on one side. He flipped a switch and the glass came out to life. Tiny characters moved across the pane and tiny voices came out. Someone yelled, "It's Cinderella!" Dr. Spellbinder turned a knob into a different moving picture and appeared.
"Thanks for some boots."
He turned the knob again.
"And that's Sleeping Beauty."
Never again will you have to ask for a story, and never again will you have to imagine the pictures. Who will be the first to buy a Spellbinder story box?
I'll take one. So will I. I'll take two.
Before long, Dr. Spellbinder's cart was empty. The town square was covered with children and grown-ups all staring blankly at the little boxes.
I don't like the looks of this.
When Peddler Polly arrived at the story swap that afternoon, Town Hall was packed. The room was buzzing with talk about lost stories and Spellbinder story boxes. Finally, Mayor Bertha Bigwig took the stage. She glanced nervously around her.
Welcome to Story Swap. It is my honor to tell the first story, The Pied Piper of Hamelin.
From her seat by an open window, Peddler Polly heard a soft whir and sucking noise.
Life in the town of Hamelin was pleasant, or it would have been, if not for the
mayor turned pale.
I've lost my story.
And she ran from the stage. A horrified murmur rose in the room. Mrs. Marbles, the school teacher, tried next.
My story is Jack and the Beanstalk.
Again, Peddler Polly heard the whir and the sucking.
There once was a poor widow who had an only son named, oh no.
She fled the stage in tears. Next came Penny.
This is the myth of Pegasus.
Peddler Polly heard the noises once more.
A long time ago in Greece, there was a horse called Pegasus. This horse was special because...
Stop the swap. We can't afford to lose any more stories. It's the end of storytelling in Tail Town.
As excited talk filled the room, Peddler Polly thought she heard a cackle out the window. She looked and saw a man with a top coat and a top hat hurrying away from the buildings. He carried a large wooden box covered with switches, knobs, and dials, with a long hose attached to it.
It's Dr. Spellbinder. I better look into this.
Peddler Polly hastened from the hall. She followed Dr. Spellbinder from a distance as he left the town and made his way into the hills. At last, Dr. Spellbinder appeared through the mouth of a cave. Peddler Polly followed him and stopped in astonishment. The huge cave was filled with mechanisms and contraptions, all of them noisily pulling, pushing, pulsing, or pounding. Dr. Spellbinder stood at the workbench covered with story boxes and another strange device. He set down the big box he was carrying and patted it fondly.
3 more stories to put in my story boxes, and all thanks to my brilliant invention, the Spellbinder Story Supper. Soon I'll be able to steal stories in the world. Then everyone will need a story box, and I'll be rich.
Not if I can help it.
Peddler Polly, what are you doing here?
Putting an end to your evil plans, Spellbinder.
You'll never stop me, Peddler Polly.
Then Dr. Spellbinder grabbed the story sucker and sprinted from the cave. Down a hill sped Dr. Spellbinder while Peddler Polly puffed in pursuit. Without the story sucker, Peddler Polly was faster.
You won't catch me so easily.
He lifted the lid on the story sucker and reached in.
See how you like this story, Peddler Polly?
He threw something behind him. There was a flash of light, and out of nowhere, a huge crowd of children appeared, coming uphill towards Peddler Polly. They were led by a man in a many-colored costume, playing on a pipe.
Well, I'll be...
Peddler Polly pushed past the startled man and pressed through the crowd of mesmerized children.
It's a catchy tune, kids, but I wouldn't follow a Pied Piper.
Dr. Spellbinder was far ahead. But Peddler Polly ran hard and gained on him.
One good story deserves another.
And he reached into the story sucker. Another flash, and Peddler Polly saw a boy chopping down a gigantic beanstalk. But just then, the boy took his heels, calling,
"Heads up!"
Peddler Polly looked up and stopped just in time. A huge man tumbled from the sky and landed with an earth-shaking crash just before her.
Didn't know stories could be so dangerous.
Peddler Polly ran around the giant while she waved to the boy and called,
"Thank you, Jack."
Dr. Spellbinder had vanished behind a hill, and Peddler Polly panted after him. As she rounded the bend, she gasped. Tied to a landing platform was a lighter-than-air balloon, and Dr. Spellbinder was climbing into the basket.
Oh no, now he'll get away for sure. Unless...
It's all over now, Peddler Polly.
Dr. Spellbinder untied the rope and the balloon floated into the air.
But I think I still have one more story, and it might as well keep you busy.
If it's the one I think it is...
Dr. Spellbinder threw it to the ground. Another flash, and there stood a horse with long and graceful wings.
Pegasus.
Peddler Polly ran and leaped onto the horse and dug in her heels. The horse flapped its wings smoothly and rose into the air. Up and up it spiraled until it was flying circles around the dismayed Dr. Spellbinder.
Guess you forgot your mythology, Spellbinder. Didn't you know Pegasus was a flying horse?
Peddler Polly rode in close, grabbed Dr. Spellbinder, and flung him across the horse's back.
My story sucker!
Cried Dr. Spellbinder as the balloon floated away with his invention.
I don't guess you'll need it where you're going. For a crime like shutting up stories, a judge is sure to shut you up unhappily ever after.
A few weeks later, when all of Dr. Spellbinder's story boxes have been opened and the stories returned to their tellers, the people of Tale Town had a big storytelling festival on the town square. Mayor Bigwig announced,
"And our special guest for today is Peddler Polly."
Well, thanks. And now I'll tell a story called Peddler Polly and the Story Stealer.
And that's a tale they'll always tell in Tale Town.